with issuing new RFI by taking back hold 1 emphasis on government-to-government process and shortening the timeline from 3 years to just 1 year overall. By the second half to end of next year 2018, code of conduct for elections will be in place and thus Government of India wishes to close the deal before that timeline. During Mattis visit, he stressed that owing to commonality of 70% between F-16 Block 7F and F-35 will lead to easier transition to F-35 at a later stage. Also plan is for just first 90 F-1690 birds or 4.5 squadrons to begin with, which can go to a max of 7.5 squadrons or 150 birds, and option is given to India to upgrade the line and next produce F-35 but under limited technology transfer using Israeli modifications. Government favors the G2G deal for this particular case, with line being set up for 36 F-16 per year to begin with and later changing to 16 F-35 and 16 F-16. So F-16 Block 7F comes with full localization and transfer of F-13X engine and upgrade to India under Tata Advanced Systems Limited, TASL. Mattis also emphasized that PAF operated F-16S is entirely different in generation behind the Block 7F. In terms of capability, the present 7F is more than twice than what Block 52, so PAF F-16 are further beyond the curve. Technically, both proposals almost give the same in terms of so-called proprietary technology access other than partial code limitation in specific Gripen parts. USA government has finally given support to Gripen but expressed strong reservation against continuing USA support for a long time and said if a threat comes to US MIC and fire ecosystem, preferential treatment will be given to American companies only. Gripen E has sweetened the deal with almost 53% tech transfer agreement, but as of today Gripen E is in second position. New documents submitted by Saab shows Gripen EF has drawbacks with engine power to weight in straight line. The second problem is Gripen E fully eating out the program of LCA. Contrary to the belief that Gripen E will might be renamed as LCA MK2 or position itself as MK2, its threat is actually directly to MK1A. As Ministry of Defense pointed that post MK1A 1 squadron handover, a fresh order of 3-4 more squadrons, 60-80 aircrafts, will be placed as well. There also a report submitted from HAL as well, which has opposed Gripen E in similar language and has expressed great concern for LCA MK1/MK1A program curtailment scope. LCA FMK2 will share interiors, upgrades and almost mini subs systems with the single engine MRCA winner. This is a big letdown for Saab and Gripen E, as internal studies have revealed that integration of Safranised Kaveri comes at a much higher cost, and recertification much beyond just engine and flight performance and goes deeper into the airframe and entire U+ systems. While F-16 and Rafale don't need such modifications, there are information warfare and hacking issues in USA planes which have been bought by some of the countries who sabotaged and changed tech source codes to modify and better certain specs. India has a powerful software community, so that might be uncovered and reversed any threat and potential damage, but USA wants a user agreement to be agreed on before any make in India absolving of any such damage caused, which is why Gripen E is not already off the table. Next 2 weeks we'll see whirlwind activity with focus on building the consensus for G2G terms for LM order and F-16S procurement. If the consensus works out as per mod plan, then by October in some forward announcement is expected.